and we are in the digital fab lab. A digital fab lab is a lab of off-the-shelf equipment that is fairly inexpensive, that is used in non-conventional ways to make just about anything.
And it can be in electronics, it can be in laser engraving, it can be in 3D printing.
My name is Tim Bruning. I'm an instructor at the engineering division here at the college, and I do wood inlay. And I can use the laser to cut the groove, turn it into an outline, and get a contrasting piece of wood, cut that out, glue it in here, sand it down, and then we can have inlaid wood. We have what's called a rapid prototyping machine
that actually prints an object out of plastic, and it prints basically from the bottom up and actually creates the object.
And we have a mechanical clock here that's going to function very, very accurately.
I started with a CAD drawing of all my gears and of my number wheels. I put it into a program that we use. I used that to tell the laser exactly what paths to cut on. I took it in and put it on the ShopBot, and I smoothed out both sides, and I also peg drilled the holes for all of my shafts, then basically just put the shafts in and put the gears on the shafts.
Behind me over here is a 3D printer. Looks like a big refrigerator. It cost over $30,000. Back here behind you is a little box about as big as two shoe boxes. It's got a bunch of wires sticking out of it. It's called a MakerBot. Costs $500. It does the very same thing that this $30,000 3D printer does over here. It's a little smaller, it's not quite as fine, but with that MakerBot, you can make another MakerBot. And because the design is not proprietary, I can buy one of those, share it with you, and you can make all your own pieces for your own MakerBot.
It's open shareware, and someone from around the world will grab it, they'll improve it, they'll make something, and then they'll post their design, you know, back up to be shared.
And everybody benefits from that kind of creative sharing.
Because there are fab labs around the world, we are able to be connected through our Polycom to those fab labs pretty much 24/7. Whenever we're in here, there's someone, you know, always on in Norway or Spain or Africa.
This is open 35 hours a week to any resident of Lorain County.
You don't have to have any prior experience in manufacturing or design. We have had students of all ages come in here. We have had children come in. We have had individuals as old as there was a gentleman who was 87.
Basically, a fab lab is a bunch of tools for creation, and you use them safely, you use them to construct, not to destruct, and you work with other people who enjoy making things with you.